Further discussion? The gentleman from St. Charles, for what purpose do you rise?
To speak on the bill, please.
Proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The gentleman from St. Louis is absolutely correct. This is unconstitutional. There's no question in my mind. This is blatant viewpoint discrimination. But let's set that aside. Let's ask if this is good policy. Do we want, as a matter of course, this body to be telling individuals, and make no mistake, corporations are made up of individuals. They're not just a piece of paper in a file room. They are people. Do we want the government to tell individuals what kinds of political views they can or cannot hold in order to do business with the state? Is that a road we want to go down? I would say no. Not just because I'm concerned that someone else may propose a bill down the line that discriminates against a viewpoint that I actually hold. I have no sympathy with the folks that are boycotting Israel, but it's just, as a matter of course, a terrible idea to shut down discussion using the force of government. That's the reason we have the First Amendment. If we can't stand up for positions that we disagree with, we don't stand for free speech. You stand for a monolithic block of thought. That's dangerous. And as well-intentioned as this may be, and as much as Israel may be our friend and an ally, you don't support your friends by hurting your own people. And that's what this does. It infringes upon the right to boycott, the right to have private political views. If we were arguing that membership or donating to an organization that was actively engaging in terrorist behavior was the reason to disqualify someone from a contract, I could say there might be an argument there, because obviously engaging in terrorism is a crime. Engaging in boycott is not a crime. That's speech. It should stay speech. It should stay protected, and we should respect that. So for those reasons, I'm going to be voting no, and I would urge the body to do the same. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.